In the dusty world of the courts of law, one judge has recently had the courage to open his mouth and blow away some of the cobwebs of tradition and hypocrisy which sometimes cloud the pure waters of justice. He's arguably Britain's best known and indeed most notorious judicial figure. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Sir James Beauchamp.
Good to see you, Judge. Well, I say Judge because you're actually, sort of suspended at the moment, aren't you?
Yes, I'm temporarily suspended for some mistake, judicial mistake, apparently, yeah. I was deemed to have made.
Yes, yeah, being considered by an inquiry.
It's being considered by my peers, and we should get the result very soon. Yes. There was an incident arising from a defendant being shot.
Yes.
In court.
By you.
By myself.
Yes.
A particularly unpleasant young woman with specs who was up on a charge of shoplifting.
Yes.
And I really became extremely irritated with her because her testimony was obviously full of holes and completely untrue.
Yes.
And momentarily, losing patience, I just vaulted over the dock and got her straight to the heart with a little Derringer I always carry in this pocket.
Well, I hope you haven't got it now, but capital punishment has been abolished for some time now.
Yes, it has, except in my neck of the woods. it's very much an individual choice, I think, whether one executes. Yeah. And it is a deterrent, I think.
Well, I suppose so, but it's very much you as a judge taking the law into your own hands.
Well, who better to take the law into their own hands than a judge?
Yeah. But you come from a long line of judges, though, don't you? Your father was a judge before you.
My father was a judge before, yes, and his grandfather was a judge.
Before him?
Before him, yes. Long before him, actually. We go back in sequence.
Yes.
As far as one can remember.
Now, you've always had, I've no doubt, a sort of strong sense of right and wrong. Even at school, didn't you?
I hanged a boy at school. Yeah. It was really dumb insolence was the... he was looking at me in that particular way, you know.
Yeah.
Irritating look. And, I say I hung him. Or is it hanged? I never know which... I strung him up. And,
And was he your fag?
He was my best friend.
Until the hanging incident, obviously.
Yes, well, we cut him down in time. He didn't pass away, thank God.
Oh, well,
I'd have been in terrible trouble.
Yes. But now, you've been involved in some notorious cases. The Tiverton 12, that was one of yours, wasn't it?
There was a great deal of press comment about my jailing 12 people for life for stealing some coffees.
Yes.
But that was not so much the crime that I jailed them for. It was the intent beyond the crime.
Yeah.
Well, because having stolen the toffees, in my view, though it was never proved.
Yes.
Having stolen the toffees, they then got into a first-class carriage between Bristol and Plymouth and started smoking.
Yes. But although they spent, I think, 20 years in custody, it was later proved it wasn't them at all.
It was another 12 from the same area.
Yeah. British justice has come in for quite a few knocks recently, mainly your cases, it has to be said, but quite a few others. Do you think British justice is still the best in the world, or is it...
I think if you have committed a crime, this is not a particularly good country to live in.
Yeah.
But if you're wholly innocent and have never been arrested, this is as good a place as any to stay indoors and thank your lucky stars.
Well, a lot of people say there's like one law for the rich, another for the poor.
Well, this is all written down, of course it is. There's one law for the rich. There's several laws for the rich and very few for the poor. Lots of laws for the rich. Most of them pretty good. Fairly lenient. Fairly lenient to the rich.
Yeah.
Because there is a difference in the rich and the poor.
The
amount of money.
Yes.
And obviously, you can afford more law if you're rich than if you're poor.
So there's lots of laws for the rich.
Lots of laws for the rich. They can pick and choose whichever one really suit them.
Yeah.
And the poor have to make do with the national health or whatever it's called.
Yes, legal aid.
Legal aid.
A lot of people say that the judges people like you, they don't like you, they rather dislike you, but the judges are out of touch. Now, how would you, you're not in touch with real people.
Of course I'm in touch with real people. I do everyday things. I go to sleep in the evening, I wake up, I have breakfast.
But are you in touch with, like, sort of the television programs?
I watch a great deal of television. I enjoy a lot of it. The gladiator stuff, very, very good.
Yes.
That's about it, really. Yes. I just watch that. All the Saturday.
And do you think that gives you a feeling for those?
Gives me a feeling of what it's like out there.
Yes. Now, does any of this sort of damage your relationship with your wife at all?
Not really. My wife, as you know, is slightly physically impaired. She fell off a horse. Was pushed off a horse. Nobody really knows. Yeah. But
you were there. You must know.
Well, I thought she fell, but yes. Very hard to tell at that speed.
Yes.
And there were those particular hedges.
Yes.
With barbed wire. But a very nasty fall, and she's partially paralysed, and one side is completely immobile. So she's very plucky, but I mean, she, you know, she can serve drinks, but not peanuts at the same time. I think she'll fall through.
Well, we wish her well. We have to leave it there. Thank you very much, Sir James Beecham. Okay, let's do.